You got the point? Yes? Right? Wireframe and information architecture. So usually people use so many tools. There are so many tools out there to do this wireframe information architecture. Now the client says, then the next thing, what the client says, you give it to clients. You take 2-3 days of time to read the docs, what else he need. And the other question you have to ask him is like, do you have anything in your mind? Any website in your mind so that you want me to take inspiration? Okay, so he gives some websites. If he has inspiration, he gives some website, or else it's your job to, okay. So do you guys know which website does this? What is that website which does this? Do you know? If I have to take inspiration, what should be that website? Do you guys know anything about it? No? Yes? No? No idea? It's Pinterest. So Pinterest does the same thing. So Pinterest is the most, what I say, it's growing pretty heavily, Pinterest. Okay, Pinterest, it's a Flickr. Again, Flickr is something on the same lines of Pinterest. Okay, so now the client may not know, but I know. Okay, this guy is trying to build a Pinterest. Fine, let me take some inspiration from Pinterest. So I take inspirations, I give wireframes, I give information architecture. I say, hey, are you okay with this flow and are you okay with these designs? He says, most probably he says, no, change this. Yeah, I'll make the changes. Then the next big part. Okay, then the next part is design. So you use Photoshop to give designs. These are essentially PSDs, Photoshop designs. So now what happens is you have to fill that skeleton. Right, you have to fill your skeleton with colors, images, fonts. Okay, so that's when the Photoshop design comes. You design it, you show the PSDs to the client, say, okay, this is all you wanted. This is how it looks like when the website is done. Okay, do not jump onto PSDs. This is a mistake most people do, because to design a PSD, it takes a lot of time. Okay. To design a wireframe, multiply it by 10 times, that is the amount of time it takes for PSDs. So most of the people do this mistake. They feel like, I don't have to lose this client, so let me show him immediately these PSDs. But that's a bad idea, because now some clients say, after looking at wireframes, clients say, I'm not getting anything from this. What is this? I mean, you said, you know, typical, I'll show you how a wireframe looks like, okay? Let me share my screen here. So you guys have time, right? If I continue the class for another 15 minutes. Yes. Is this information helping you guys? And topic says, oh, you don't want, okay, you're going fine. Okay, fine. So you guys, Google it. I don't want to eat up your time. Okay, so I'll just show you wireframes. Okay, images. So this is how a wireframe look like. If you guys can see the screen here. So this is small actually. Let me pull in a big one. So this is something, a wireframe. It doesn't have fancy colors, it doesn't have fancy fonts. It says, okay, here comes a logo, search bar, blah 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 blah. Okay, so client may say, okay, I'm not getting it, man, come on, I need PSDs. But say, hey, no, this is how the skeleton looks like, this is how what you asked for. Then give him the PSDs. Then as you know, your design team, let's say if you have a design team, if your design team is working on these PSDs, the next thing you are supposed to do is, what are the things which are to be stored in database? So now the next piece is database design. Okay, what are the essential things that are to be stored in the database? So that's the next step. As soon as you're with the PhDs, so the next is database. Now here, I'll open a new thing here. So I'll stop this. So now what happened? We have PhDs, right? We have PhDs from wireframes to PhDs. From PhDs, it gets separated. Here, the HTML, I call this as front end, and the dynamic content. So it gets separated to dynamic and static content. So static content is all the HTML part, and dynamic content is my PHP and database. Okay, so first thing you gotta do is like design the database. This is the most important part. If at all any web pages which fail, they fail only because of the database design. Okay, this is the most important part. You have to spend your most of the time into database design, because you cannot change this dynamically. Once you have made your database design, it takes a lot. If you make, let's say, yeah, for silly changes, for 1 or 2, 3, 4 changes, fine. If you have to change like say 10-15 tables, yeah, it cannot happen immediately. So it takes time. So spend your most of the time in database design, which Tutors Life concentrates most on database design. Okay, this is what we do. How do you design a database? What should you take care of while designing a database? So the whole of the performance of a web application depends upon database design. So here comes the performance. Now we talk about performance. Now we talk about security here. Okay, performance and security comes in database design. Right? So then database design is done. You just design your database. At least some part of database you will be designing. You won't be designing the whole lot of everything. You just design whatever which is needed to take off the project. Okay, then by the end you figure out your HTML will be done, then start integrating or making it dynamic. So how do you make it dynamic? You take HTML, okay, put PHP into it, use database and complete the application. Right, so this is last part. So then this is not just the last part. The last part is testing it. So you test it for bugs, performance, performance and security and etc. Okay, this is the whole part. This is how someone should approach in building web applications. It does not happen like what we think. You know what most of the people out there do? They teach PHP. Okay, now you know PHP. Okay, fine, Taufik, you go and do a project. So now you go and someone in your project will give you, okay, only do this piece. Okay, Taufik, just do this registration and login from that side, they say. Okay, yeah, you can do that. You will do that, definitely. But now, as time passes, and let's say after 2 years, okay, then you feel like you won't be doing login forms. Then he says, hey, Taufik, do you know MySQL and database design? Then you will like, you know, It's a particular thing then. Like you feel like, okay, now all the while I have done this coding, now why should I learn MySQL database design? So that's not a good thing to do then. It's always better to go from scratch, from start. Anytime you learn something, learn from the scratch. That gives a fair idea. Most of the people out there say, hey, no, I only need this. Okay, tell me how to do a PHP session. Yeah, that's it. If you want that, I can tell that too. But that is not my motto. My motto is you guys have to build sustainable products, not like products which is for the sake of products, sustainable products, reusable products and stuff. So people who missed out my JavaScript, jQuery, CSS classes, there are videos. Go through the videos. Any question, come back to the class and say, hey, video number 53, I did not understand. What is it? Now, then I can make a notes for you. You guys know how to use a website, right? Shall I show it how to use a website? Most probably you guys know about that. Fine. So with that, I'll be ending the class. So from tomorrow, not tomorrow, we don't have classes on Saturdays and Sundays, okay? Only on Fridays. Oh, sorry, not on Fridays. Monday to Friday, we have the class. So Saturday, Sunday, I'll leave up to you guys. We follow the corporate style here. And from Monday and Tuesday, I'll be teaching you basics of PHP. So I hope you guys go and follow how to install XAMPP. Okay, so this is one thing I need from you guys. XAMPP, try to install it. Google XAMPP, download for Windows, Mac, Linux, whatever you have. Download, install. It's simple. It won't ask you any questions. All you gotta do is like next. Install. Then after doing that, go to htdocs. This will be installed here. If you have Windows, it's in C folder, C XAMPP. This is your XAMPP, and all we need here is three folders. Okay, I'll be showing those three folders. So just give me 2 minutes. Okay, I'll finish the class. So it's here. Okay, C XAMPP. This is XAMPP. All we need is this folder. This folder and this folder and this folder, four folders: Apache, htdocs, MySQL and PHP. Okay, all we need is Apache. Apache is a web server. We need this. The configuration files of Apache will be inside Apache, and configurations of MySQL in MySQL, configurations of PHP in PHP, and our actual code will be in this folder. So as soon as you install, go to this folder, delete everything which is inside that folder. Okay, delete everything which is inside that folder, then come to class. So we'll start from there.